Baseball is the great American pastime. Children, parents, and grandparents alike have welcomed baseball into their homes and their hearts for decades. Coming from your typical hot dog and apple pie eating working class family, it seems only appropriate to say that my life is like a baseball game. Now, whether you're a Mets fan or a Yankees fan, or whether your alliance is with one of the other 28 teams, all 30 major league teams have something in common. All 30 teams have a manager, coaches, and a regular defense, unless, of course, you're the 2009 New York Mets. Like these teams, I, too, have a manager, coaches, and a defense. Mine is a lot different than the Jose Reyes's, Ichiro Suzuki's, and Hanley Ramirez's of the world. However, the concepts are the same. This is my manager. Like Joe Torre, he calls the shots and makes all the decisions, and whether I agree with them or not, I have no choice but to abide by them. Managers make bad decisions all the time, and in my case, the bad decisions are the events in my life which have sometimes caused me to question my faith, but in the end, he has led me to many winning seasons. These are my coaches. On a major league team, coaches are those people under the manager who specialize in certain areas to help you improve your game. In my case, my coaches are my guardian angels who help guide me every day in my life and protect me in ways that nobody on this earth can. They are my paternal grandparents, Louise and Frank, and my late boyfriend and first true love, Patrick. On the field, the pitcher controls the game. The pitcher can slow down or speed up the pace of a game and is instrumental in a team's success or failure in a game. I am the pitcher. I control my life and everything about it. However, even the Tom Seavers and the Johan Santanas of the world need a defense, as do I, and here they are. My catcher is my boyfriend, Mike. He helps me call each pitch I make. Since we've been going out, he's always been there to be my co-pilot and my best friend, and like the relationship between a pitcher and a catcher, we have a mutual understanding, respect, and love for each other that people who aren't involved just won't understand. My parents are my middle infielders. They are directly behind me on every play, and I am confident in their solid support. My parents have always given me every opportunity to succeed, much like two Gold Glove infielders do for a 20-game winner. A pitcher is only as good as his defense, and in my case, I'm a Cy Young candidate. My center fielder and the last piece of my middle defense is my Aunt Christina. She is not only my aunt, but my godmother as well. On a major league team, the center fielder fields the line drives and ground balls that get past the second baseman and shortstop. In my case, my aunt helps me deal with those things that parents just don't quite understand. As my uncle by marriage, I was always more shy around my Uncle Mario than I was around my blood relatives. On a baseball team, whether it be the majors or even in Little League, it is believed that the right fielder is the weakest of the three outfielders. Similarly, my relationship with my uncle was always weaker than mine with my other family members. However, just like a right fielder can make an outstanding play to rob a home run, my uncle has always been there on short notice whenever I've needed him. My maternal grandparents platoon left field. They live with my family and I, and on any given day, either one of them will be subject to listening to me sound off on my day. Being that the majority of hitters are right-handed, the left fielder takes a beating on a daily basis in a major league environment. In my case, I'm easily annoyed, and my grandparents are always there to switch off and play solid defense when the heavy hitters, namely aggravation, fights with my parents, and morons at work, step up to bat. At my hot corner is my brother Frankie. Just like a third baseman is quick with a glove, my brother is always quick with a wisecrack. The pitcher and the third baseman may not always communicate, but when the pitcher needs solid defense, the third baseman is always there.